feitiço. Meu sangue mula tu.
Before to start, I want to lead us in prayer. O our good Father in heaven, you are the Holy One. At this time, we all want to come and to just finish to close the Sabbath. O Lord, in this hour, during this short hour, we will study your word, and everything that will be said during this study is coming from you, O Lord. To help every brothers and sisters in the church to testify your name to the world and to preach your holy word to the world. Lord, help us to have unity, and may your Holy Spirit be with the brethren and the young people to preach your gospel, which is holy. Be with me at this moment. Put the word in my mouth. May your Holy Spirit guide me not to share my but your thoughts, so we can all help each other. And Lord, help me at this time to preach your holy word. At this hour, I ask you your presence. This is my prayer in the name of him who died on the cross for our sins. Amen. Greetings to every brothers and sisters all over the world. And for this reason, I want to thank the Lord. I asked him the privilege to study with you this morning a special subject, Save, Serve, Isaiah 6, verse 8. Also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then said I, Here am I, send me. We don't have any time to lose. The hand is near. The last work God wants us to do in Revelation 14, verse 6. And I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel, to preach unto them that dwell on earth, and to every nation, and kindred, and tongue, and people. In the spirit of prophecy, Testimonies, the Church, Volume 9, page 117. The salvation of sinners requires earnest personal labor. We are to bear to them the word of life, not to wait for them to come to us. Oh, that I could speak words to men and women that would arouse them diligent action. The moments now granted to us are few. We are standing upon the very borders of the eternal world. We have no time to lose. Every moment is golden and altogether too precious, devoted merely to self-serving. Who will seek God earnestly and from him draw strength and grace to be his faithful workers in the missionary field? To whom God gave this work to preach the gospel of the Lord? Mark 16, verse 15 and 16. And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. 16, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. The prophecy of the parable, Christ Object Lesson, page 300. Service to God includes personal ministry. By personal efforts, we are to cooperate with him for the saving of the world. Christ's commission, Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature, is spoken to us, to every one of his followers, all who are ordained to work for the salvation of their fellow men. Their hearts will throb in unison with the heart of Christ. The same longing for souls that he has felt will be manifest in them. Not all can fill the same place in the work, but there is a place and a work for all. And read also in Concerts to Teachers, Parents, and Students, page 466, the Savior's commission to the disciples includes all believers to the end of time, all to whom the heavenly inspiration has come our acute interest with the gospel. All who receive the life of Christ are ordained to work for the salvation of their fellow men. For this work, the church was established, and all who take upon themselves its sacred vows are thereby pledged to be co-workers with Christ. So we, as Christ's people, chosen by God, we all have to cooperate with Christ for the work of God. The angel's ministry is very important also for us in God's work. How the holy angels participate in the terrestrial activities. Hebrews 1 verse 13 and 14. But to which of the angels said he at any time, Sit on my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool? How then are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? Let's read together in the Acts of the Apostles, page 134. As his representatives among men, God does not choose angels who have never fallen, but human beings, men of light, patient with those they seek to save. Christ took humanity that he might reach humanity. A divine human savior was needed to bring salvation to the world, and to men and women has been committed the sacred trust of making known the unsearchable riches of Christ. Ephesians 3 verse. In his wisdom, the Lord brings those who are seeking for truth to touch with fellow beings who know that it is the plan of heaven that those who have received light shall impart it to those in darkness. Humanity drawing its efficiency from the great source of wisdom is made the instrumentality, the working agent through which the gospel exercises its transforming power on mind and heart. God needs men who know the truth, preach the truth to the world. A work for the master. In Mark 16, verse 15, the same verse where God calls us to go and work in the world, and this verse in Mark 16, verse 16, I love this verse and I always repeat this verse in my study. Mark 16, verse 15. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. The spirit of prophecy in French, Jesus Christ, page 6b5. Those who are waiting for the Lord with diligence purify their souls by obeying to the truth and join at this waiting and intense activity. They know that the Lord is coming, so their desire to cooperate with divine agencies for the salvation of souls. It is important. The important thing is to obey to the truth, because God calls us to go into all the world, but God's people must obey to the truth, obey to the word of God, and also cooperate with the Lord. Of the Lord, on which base every Christian, man, woman, married, single, rich, poor, from any ethnical origin, and no matter the age, is officially allowed to testify his Lord and Master Jesus Christ. John 15, verse 15, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain. That whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father in my name, he may give it to you. God chooses. We didn't choose Jesus, but he chooses in the family to go and preach his word. Galatians 3 verse 27 and 28. For as many of you as have been baptized into Christ, have put on Christ, there is neither Jew nor Greek, there is neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus. There is neither Jew nor Greek, there is no more families in the church, because for ye are all one in Christ Jesus. That is why God chooses for his work. Education, page 263. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. In Mark 16, verse 15. Is Christ's command to his followers? This is Christ's command. This is not the minister command or the Bible worker command. Christ's command to his followers. Not that all are called to be ministers or missionaries in the ordinary sense of the term, but all may be workers with him in giving the glad tidings to their fellow men. To all, great or small, learned or ignorant, old or young, the command is given. God chooses his people. This command came from Christ. This command not came from us. Preach the word. God himself sent us to preach his word. In the spirit of prophecy, Evangelist, page 69, when I think of the cities, because there is island There is cities, when I think of the cities in which so little work has been done, in which there are so many thousands to be warned of the soon coming of the Savior, I feel an intensity of desire to see men and women going forth to the work in the power of the Spirit, filled with Christ's love for perishing souls. We need men and women, and also young people, to go forth to the work in the power of the Holy Spirit. To work in this world, we don't need our knowledge or our strength, but the strength of the Holy Spirit. Has God given us the Holy Spirit so we can be able to work in this world? Dedicate ourselves to preach about the last day events. Question: what special signification the everlasting gospel have nowadays? Ecclesiastes 12, verse 13 and 14. Let us hear the conclusion of war matter. Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of men. All the men in the world must preach the gospel. Say unto men to observe the commandments of the Lord. Verse 14, for God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. And the other verse in Revelation 14, verse 6 and 7, and I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on earth, unto every nation and kindred and tongue and people. Verse 7, they said with a loud voice, fear God, and to Him be the glory, because His judgment is come. Praise Him who made the sky, the heaven, the earth, the sea, and the sources of water. In the spirit of prophecy, in the parables, page 192, it is clearly explained in the verse in Revelation or Ecclesiastes, the preaching of the churchmen shows us of the soon coming of the Lord. How this preaching is also called the everlasting evangel, gospel, the everlasting gospel. The relative predication about the imminent, the soon coming of the Christ is an essential part of our message. In the spirit of prophecy, which is right in English, right? Life sketches, page 209. Your light shall not be under a wood or under a bed, but on a chandelier, so it can shine upon all the people who is in the house. Your house, it's the world. Your homes, brothers and sisters, it's the world. Our home, it's the world. We must go to work and shine upon people in this world. There is many families in this world, souls in this world. The church mission in Mark, I love to repeat this verse, in Mark chapter 16, verse 15. And He said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. The church in Acts of the Apostles, page 9, the church is God's agency for the salvation of men. It was organized for service, and its mission is to carry the gospel to the world. Church is God's agency, because in the church of God, there are the brothers and the sisters, there are spirit of prophecy, there are Bible, many ways to preach the word of God. The mission of the church, because the church also have its mission, what great mission, which requires a serious organization, was given to the church. Matthew 28, verse 18 to 20, and Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Verse 19, go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Verse 20, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded, and so I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Thank the Lord, because He never let us alone to work for Him, because Jesus said, and so I am with you always. Always means like every day we work for Him, but Jesus is here with Him. Work here with us. He is working with us. The Lord never forgets His servant. He is always working with us, because the Bible said, and so I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Testimony, Treasures, Volume 1, page 359. The mission of the Church of Christ is to save perishing sinners. It is to make known the love of God to men and to win them to Christ by the efficacy of that love. Truth for this time must be carried into the dark corners of the earth, and this work may begin at home. The command for us, Christ command for us, before to leave this earth, what did Jesus ask His disciples to do? This is the same verse again in Mark 16, verse 15. The verse in Mark can read this verse two or three times to wake up the brethren in the church, to wake up to go work for God. Mark 16, verse 15, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Question, how did the Lord announce the realization of this mission? In Matthew 24, verse 14, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached to all the world for a witness unto all the nations. This is the mission. God gives this mission, to go and preach the good news of the kingdom in all the world for witnesses, testify Jesus in the world. Question, by which geographical order the apostles have to preach the gospel before? Acts 1, verse 8. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all the Judea, in the Samaria, until the uttermost of the world. You will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all the Judea, in the Samaria, until the uttermost of the world. God sends us to testify. There is a lot of countries, a lot of tribes, a lot of families, and we, you and me, we have to testify the Christ. Don't stay at home. We have to work, the young people, the old, the ministers, even the Bible workers. This is the time to testify Christ. Question, what particular mission the Lord has gave Paul? Because in the Sabbath school, it talks about Paul. Acts 26, verse 17 and 18, delivering tea from the people and from the Gentiles, and to whom now I send thee to open their eyes and turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan unto God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and inheritance among them which are sanctified by faith that is in me. God chooses in the midst of these people, in the midst of this country, and in the midst of the unbelievers, sends us to open their eyes. Because in this world, the people who are living this world are blind because of the darkness. But we, as God's people, with Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, with the power of God, we will open their eyes because they are blind. Question, on which central subject a Christ ambassador must preach? Let's see in 2 Corinthians 4, verse 5, for we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus, the Lord. For we preach not ourselves. We preach the name of who? The name of Christ. This is our central goal. Sometimes we preach the spirit of prophecy, but they don't know about the spirit of prophecy. But we must preach the name of Jesus. Because in the Bible, in 2 Corinthians 4, verse 5, it tells us, for we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord. Question: what is the quality that an evangelist must have? 2 Timothy 2, verse 24 and 25. And the servant of the Lord must not strive, but be gentle unto all men, apt to teach, patient, in meekness, instructing those that oppose themselves, if God peradventure will give them repentance to the acknowledging of the truth. It talks about the servant of the Lord. The servant of the Lord must not strive. The brothers and sisters must not strive, because all of them have to go and preach the word of God. We must be gentle, we must be patient towards Paul. But before going, we must not strive, because we are all going to work for the Lord to reach souls. When he had presented to sinners the requirements of the divine law, the preacher must not forget that the love of God is the only power which ever touched the heart of his hearers and to lead them to the repentance and to the obedience. He must remember also that his essential work consists not to condemn fellow men, but to save them. We preachers not to strive before preach, and we preachers preach about love, but not to condemn anyone. Our duty is to preach the love of Christ. Christ will work in the heart. Christ will bring this soul in the church. This is Christ who brings the souls in the church. We are just co-workers. We don't have the power to convert anyone. This is the Spirit of God who will convert the souls to come in the church. Question: why did he ask them to stay sometimes in Jerusalem before start preaching? This is a question that he asked us. Before we go to preach, there is something to do for us to do. All Christians, for God's people, for young people. Luke 24, verse 49. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. There is a power that God promises as God's people. He promises that He will send a power. We shall receive a power, the Holy Spirit, to go and to preach in the world the gospel. First, we must ask the Holy Spirit, because it's the Holy Spirit guide us. This is the Holy Spirit who gives us good thoughts to convert someone. But we must have power. Yeah, this is true. It's true. God sent us to preach his gospel all around the world, into all the world. But we must have the power of the Holy Spirit. And this is why God told to his disciples, stay in Jerusalem, he shall receive a power. This is the God's promise, he shall receive a power. Question: what gave power to the apostles to preach the gospel with strength? Acts 1, verse 8. But you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and to the uttermost part of the heart. We must be thankful to the Lord because the Lord helps us to work in this world. He already knows that the souls in this world, they are blind because of the worldly pleasures. But we, as Christians, we don't have power. As Christians, we don't have power. We must cooperate with the Holy Ghost. And this is why it tells us in Acts 1, verse 8, you shall receive a power, the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is come upon you. We must ask Christ, we must ask God to send us this power. Question, what were the results of the predication in Jerusalem? What were the results of the disciples after receiving the Holy Spirit? In Acts 4, verse 4, obeyed many of them which heard the word believed, and the number of the men was about 5,000. But how 5,000 men can obey? It's because of the power of the Holy Spirit. We must ask the Holy Spirit to help us. And this is the Holy Spirit who will convince the soul. And the results they had by receiving the Holy Spirit, we see it in Acts 4, verse 4. 5,000 men lead to obey with the power of the Holy Spirit. Question, what is the promise that was made to the faithful messengers of the Word of God? Let's read in Psalms 126, verse 6. Psalms 126, verse 6. He that goeth forth and weepeth, bearing precious seeds, shall doubtless come again with rejoicing, bringing his sheaves with him. We do missionary work. We work for Christ. You and me must not forget that this is true. When you bring your sheaves, you bring the Word of God, or you bring the gospel, good news. And when you came back to your home, when you came back to the church, the verse tells us that with rejoicing, it is better to give. This is true, and weep it because there is many difficulties, there is many trials. But when you came back to your home, or when you came back to the church, this is again with rejoicing. You are thankful to be alive. Question, what were the fruits of this missionary action? Let's read in Acts 11, verse 21. And the hand of the Lord was with them, and a great number believed and turned unto the Lord. Amen. Thanks the Lord. You see, because the Lord never forgets his servant. And you can read, the Bible said, and the hand of the Lord was with them. And the hand of the Lord is with us to remove any things that blocks us to work for Christ. And the hand of the Lord is with us to remove all these things, because Satan's already know. Satan already know. He already knows that the Church of God has a special gospel to preach to this world. And Satan already knows. He already knows the gospel. And Satan will prepare things to block God's people to go preaching the Word of God. But in the Bible, the verse said, and the hand of the Lord was with them to remove the work of the heaven. Thanks the Lord, because he is always there with us. And this is the most important. You know, when you do missionary works, young people and old members, when they read their Bibles, they can see the hand of God in their life. We can read in the Bible that the hand of the Lord is with them. Question, is it only by their words that Christians will be called to testify for the gospel. Let's read together in 2 Corinthians 3, verse 2 and 3. Ye are, this is you, this is us, the believers, this is us, believers, this is you, believers, this is us all, everyone. We are believers. We believe in God. We have faith in God. Ye are our epistle. Write them in our hearts, known and read of all men. For as much as ye are manifestly declared to be the epistle of Christ ministered by us, write them not with ink, but with the Spirit of the living God, not in tables of stone, but in fleshy tables of the heart. Everyone, you and me, everyone who is in the church, the young people, the old members, this is written in our hearts. The epistles, and in the Bible, it said, ye are our epistles, written in our hearts. This is in our hearts. In the Sabbath school, we also talk about the Ten Commandments, the Ten Commandments, the New Covenant. This is written in our hearts. Now, all the Gospel of the Epistle are written in your heart, and we are all light in this world. Question regarding what Jesus said, how everyone is called to preach the gospel, we will read together in Luke 10, verse. Therefore, said unto them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Pray ye, therefore, the Lord of the harvest, that he would send forth laborers into his harvest. God needs everyone. God needs us. God needs Bible workers. God needs ministers. God needs young people. Save the souls. We are all instruments that God chooses to preach his name into all the world, into the nation, to the souls. God needs everyone in the church to preach the name of Jesus unto the nation and to the souls. An example of Paul, an example of Paul in Philippians 3, verse 12 to 14, not as though I had already attained either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. But I follow after. We must follow after Christ. We must run into this world and preach the gospel, if that I may apprehended that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Verse 13. Brethren, I come not myself to have apprehended, but this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind, and reaching forth unto those things which are before. Forget the things that are in the back, in the past, forgetting those things which are behind, and reach forth unto those things which are before. There is many souls before you that is needed to be saved. There is so many families before you that is needed to be saved, because the time is near. Jesus' second coming is soon. Verse 14, I press. The Apostle Paul, he don't stay at home like this. He is running. He said, I press. We must run. We must press to work for the Lord. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Let's read together also in 2 Timothy 4, verse 8, henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them also that love is appearing. In this verse, the Apostle Paul is encouraging us. The Apostle Paul is encouraging us for the crown of righteousness. And this crown of righteousness, it is not only for him, for Paul, but it is for everyone. Because it is true, God gave the knowledge to everyone, to the old people, to the young people, to the ministers, to the Bible workers. God gave to us all the knowledge. God also gave us the truth. And now, to close my presentation, this is with the promise. The promise of Jesus for those who are working and working and working for Christ. The promise that we found in Revelation 22, verse 12. And behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be. May the Lord bless his holy word. Amen. Now, before to close my presentation, I want to lead us again in prayer. Let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, who stand on your holy throne in the most holy places, you are the Holy One. And at this hour, O Lord, I come unto thee, O Lord. And I want to thank you. Thank you for your holy word that has been shared with everyone. Every spirit of prophecies you gave us during this study to help all the churches. Help also young people. Help the brothers and the sisters. Help also the ministers and the Bible workers. Help them all, O Lord, so that they may be able to preach your holy word. And we want to ask you again, your Holy Spirit, to help us all the way, to help us to work for you, O Lord. Thank you, Lord, to have put the words in my mouth. And, O Lord, please give the understanding to all the brothers and the sisters who will hear this study for this morning. We submit all in thy hands. And, O Lord, may you be with me too. Help us, be with us. As long as we go back to our homes, be with us and protect us during all this day. Here is my prayer in the holy name of him who died on the cross for all our sins. Amen.
Peace out.